Hi, I'm Rick with Bare Naked Decoys. We sell a dual-purpose goose decoy, which serves as a field or as a floater. We have a removable keel and a removable metal stand. The metal stand slips in to the base of the goose. Gives you your field standing goose. We also have screw-on heads that go on very easily, which allows you to position these geese heads in different areas. Field feeder, field rester, the keel. Also slides in the same spot very easily in your floater. With the heels, when we ship them empty. They can both be filled with sand, or you can drill out the hole on each end of the keel. And let the water be your weight. So today we're going to show you how easy it is to paint these, and I think you'll be able to save a lot of money by doing it yourself. Plus you'll be able to change it from Canadians to Snows, Speckled, whichever you prefer. So let's get started and see you in a minute. Okay. Prepare the goose for paint. We're going to use a technique called flaming, and what that does is basically it's like scuffing a car. You're going to need a plumber's torch, and it's very simple. You want to just go over it, keep your flame about a quarter inch off the top of the plastic, and go over it real quick. I'll demonstrate. But it's a real quick process, and it's going to help a great deal with your paint sticking. And there you go. We're all set. Now we can paint this bird, and the paint's going to stick a lot better than if you just spray it on. Okay, so we're going to paint these geese. You're going to need a flat black for the head, some white for the tail feathers, some brown for feathering, and then a khaki color for the base coat. And if you want these all to be flat, I bought this paint at my local hardware store. So it's really easy. So we'll get started here. It's also, you cover the whole thing in your khaki, and it gives you a nice base coat for the rest of your paint to stick to. So don't be afraid to cover everything that you need to cover. left from the plastic. You just don't want that on there. And I know a lot of guys like to flock their heads and everything, which is a real nice finished product. But with the flocking, it's a lot harder to change them over from a Canadian to say like a snow goose, because you've got to get rid of that flocking, where this way you just get a can of white paint out and some khaki, and you can change this Canadian right back into a snow goose real quick. So there, we've got a head and a body, and let those other ones dry. Paint another head really quick. As you can see, I'm going to come around the table here. You take it, mark out your breasts, and then just continue feathering the back as well. And there's your body. Now what you're going to do is you're going to put a little band around the goose head. Okay, we're going to paint the head, and then that's going to be it. And we're all set with these. We're going to put the little white feathers around the neck and the head. So, what we do is I just take a little paint that I use on the tail, put a spray in there, and we're good to go. I've already done that. You want to let it set up so it doesn't, so it's not so runny if you do that, or you can just buy some regular paint. A little brush. Just go down, make a little circle here underneath the neck. You can see this is a lot easier when people aren't watching you. Bring it up a little bit higher on the eye. And it's pretty simple stuff to do here. So you can save yourself quite a bit of money just by painting yourself. Plus, you get together with your buddies, you paint, you know, 12, 24 of them, however you got. It doesn't take so long. It's kind of fun to get together with guys and do whatever you want. Have a little cookout, paint some birds. You know, the whole bonding thing. But there you go. That's the last of it. So now you've got a full painted bird. Let this stuff dry. I'll be back and I'll show you what it looks like all put together. All right, there we go. Got some painted piece here. Didn't take us very long to do it. I'm a painter by no means. I lay carpet for a living. So, like I said, you can do a great job. You do a poor job, whatever.